When the bright lights fade upon a simple stage, there's only one truth that always will remain. When the crowds they leave and the doors are closed, there's only one truth that we really need to know. Jesus Christ is Lord, a brother, friend, and God. He calls us out of love to live a life of prayer. I'm coming back. I'm coming back to you, Jesus. I'm coming back to you, face to face with the truth. When the days are long and we're weak and tired, it's always God's grace to keep us pressing on. When the plans they change and it all goes wrong, there's only one truth that we really need to know. Jesus Christ is Lord, a brother, friend. He calls us out of love to live a life of prayer. I'm coming back to you.
Sing it with
me. I'm coming back to you. I'm coming back to you. With the truth, and I will worship small room, and I will give praise in the choir, in adoration I surrender all to you. I worship, and I will worship in a small room.
What an incredible, incredible moment. God, the creator of the universe, the multiverse, all that you could see or imagine. God, who is so big that the world cannot contain him. Yet, here he is. And just for you. God who loves you and calls you by name, holds you in his hands. And we as his people get to kneel down before him, to adore him, to say whatever we want to him. and he's listening. And we kneel here, sometimes full of faith, but sometimes with doubt too, and that's okay. I know there are people here who come with expectation, with joy, with gratitude, because God deserves that. But there are also people here who come here with doubt and frustration, depression, addiction, anxiety, confusion. And in the presence of an almighty God, that is okay too, because God is greater. God is bigger. God is stronger. And I know there are people here, and I particularly speak out to those who are suffering from addiction, thinking that there's no way I'm going to get out of this. Jesus says, I'm bigger. Greater, I'm stronger. I have the power to break every chain, the power to make all things new, if you would just trust me. Physical ailments, sickness, God is healing. God is making all things new. How could this be real? Some are doubting and questioning, where are you, God, in all of this? How can this be? This what I'm feeling, what I'm experiencing. Is this real? This moment, Jesus looks at you and loves you. Those who look at themselves and feel unworthy of the presence of God, God runs towards you, embraces you. You are worthy because Jesus has made you worthy. Wherever you are, in a place of joy or a place of confusion, addiction, sickness, God knows. He knows those tears. He knows those frustrations. And he loves you. Jesus opens his arms at this moment and he invites you. Those of you who maybe have never encountered this relationship with God, you know about God, but you've never actually had an encounter of God. Or maybe those of you who have had this encounter with God, but can't remember the last time you felt the presence of God. And maybe you feel a million miles away. Just want you to imagine Jesus walking towards you and inviting you into relationship, back into encounter with him. So I want to pray this prayer. For those of you who are ready to get up and say yes to Jesus. Say yes to this embrace. Whether you've prayed this prayer before or this is the first time, I just want to invite you to give your heart, to give your life to this King of Kings. you can just pray this. Lord Jesus, I thank you for your love for me. I thank you that you have a plan for my life, a plan for joy, a plan for peace, and a plan for hope. Lord, I'm sorry for running away from you, for choosing myself over you, for choosing myself over others. But right here and right now, I want this to change. I want to belong to you. I want you to be first. I want you to be the Lord of my life. I'm tired of carrying this weight of sin, and I just drop it right here before you. And I thank you, Lord Jesus, that you love me just as I am, but too much to leave me in darkness. I choose light. Lord, and I thank you that you make all things new. So, Lord Jesus, here I am. I'm yours. His healing presence is here in this place. His healing hearts is reaching out to you right now. Some of you feel something that maybe you've never felt before, this joy. Just let it out. Respond. And I'm going to offer an invitation for those of you who really want to accept this invitation to make all things new. To maybe get up from your place and come here before Jesus. Come close. As a gesture, as a sign of surrender to God. So wherever you are, wherever you're kneeling, you're standing, you're sitting, just if you're ready to make all things new, you're ready to accept this embrace of God, just come. Come before the Lord. Come and surrender to Him.
Thank you. Let me chase. Let me chase down your wildest dreams. Let me see your heart. Jesus, you're all I need. Jesus, you're all I need. Your grace is enough for me. It's always been you.
So take heart, so take heart, our God has overcome. So take heart, Christ has overcome.
So take heart.
So take heart, our God has overcome.
Yes.
So take heart, Christ has overcome.
Thank you.
Jesus, I love you. I will worship you, Lord. In spirit and truth, make me new. Jesus, I love you. I will lay down my life.
Take up
your victorious cross. Jesus, I love you. I will worship you, Lord. In spirit and truth, make me new. Jesus, I love you. I will lay down my life. Take up your victorious cross.
Jesus, just say his name. Jesus, I trust in you. Just fall into his heart. Just fall into his heart. Just crash into his love. Just fall into his love. He waits for you. His mercy is new each day. And he waits for you. I sing it out, Jesus, I love you.
As we are before Jesus, who loves us, we'll praise him together. So you can repeat after me. Blessed be God. Blessed be His holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be His most holy sacred heart. Blessed be His most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary, most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. And blessed be God in his angels and in his saints.
Press on in the face. Jesus. Thank you for your mercy, Lord. We adore you, Jesus.